Bigfoot claims to have seen him. He can kill two pellets with one bird. He makes onions cry.
I don't always shoot air guns, but when I do, I prefer 30 caliber. Keep shooting, my friends. So the most interesting air gunner in the world only shoots the best of the best air guns. And today I'm looking at one of those types of guns. This is the Daystate Renegade HP, which is high powered. It is a synthetic stock bullpup design. Now, here's what's cool about this gun. First of all, this is an expensive gun. This thing goes about 1600 bucks. But you're buying a gun that puts you in a different category. The Daystate guns are kind of like the Rolls Royces or Ferraris or Bentleys of air guns. The gun itself is made with the finest materials out there. It's very sturdy. You know, it's got good weight to it. It's a very nice gun. Comes with, you know, a hard case here. This gun here is based on the kind of the Daystate flagship gun is this gun called the Pulsar. I know a lot of you guys don't know anything about Daystate. Some of you guys know everything about Daystate. So I'm going to kind of be there in the middle. The Pulsar is an electronic gun essentially, and it's awesome, and you pay for it. It's got lasers and, I mean, every bell and whistle you can imagine, it's got it. Well, this is their, I don't want to say the cheaper version, but it's based on that Pulsar, and it does come with a lot of the same features of the Pulsar, but without the electronic parts. The fully electronic parts, which you pay for extra. This gun is based on the Pulsar platform, but it has a mechanical insides. Insides are all mechanical, so you're not paying for that those electronic parts. But what this does have that makes this gun unique is, for the very first time in any high-powered air gun, it's a hybrid trigger. So it's an electronic and mechanical trigger, because in these bullpup designs, why these are special is because the barrel is 23 inches long, which is the length of a normal size barrel. But they pull everything back, and all the action, the cocking, everything that happens is back here in the back. So it allows you to get the bullpup design and feel, but yet have the full length barrel, so you're still getting the same feet per second and foot pounds. Now, that's necessary in a gun like this, because this is a 30 caliber air gun. 303, serious amounts of power. It is superior accuracy. It is a very, very nice gun, especially in a 30 caliber. You can reach out 50, 100, 150 yards pretty consistently. And we're gonna show that. We're gonna shoot groups 50 and 100 and then shoot targets all the way from 50 to 100 and everything in between to show you how accurate this gun can be. So let's go through the gun a little bit and talk about what we're looking at. So like I said, you got the synthetic stock. It's got this nice, it's this soft, I don't know what they call it, but it's just like kind of like soft synthetic feel. So it feels really good. You got a good pistol grip here. That is just nice. It's got a bunch of just different etchings and stuff on here, so you get a good feel. Going through the back, pretty much everything on this gun is adjustable in some capacity. The buttstock here is adjustable. The cheek piece is not adjustable, because this is where the action is. But you can switch over the cocking mechanism to the other side if you're a lefty. So this gun is ambidextrous. And then, you know, going through. The trigger, there's three or four different adjustments on the trigger. Like I said, it is that hybrid of mechanical and electronic. And then it doesn't come with a scope, but it just has this kind of like, it looks like kind of like a little carrying handle. And then it's an 11 millimeter dovetail here on top. But it does not come with the scope or mounts. Here in the back is where you've got where you can get your air pressure. It's a 250 bar max fill, but it's tested to 375 bar. So, you know, it's good there, but they suggest 250, between 200 and 250 bars where you're going to kind of get your sweet spot. And then let's see on top here, you've got in the 30, you've got a 5-round mag. This also comes in 22 and 25. In the 30, you get a five round mag, very easy the way it loads, very simple actually. And then you kind of got this cool thing here, which I love on a lot of the Daystate guns. This comes, it's just a little level. So when you're lined up and you get set up, you can see if you're, you know, it got your gun tilted at all. This is where you feel it's got the male disconnect there, so that's great. You're gonna get this on all Daystate guns pretty much, so you just pull out your hose, pop it on. We're gonna test that at 50 and 100, go shoot some targets, see what this thing is all about, and show you why this gun is worth the money that you pay to get it. I am using the JSB's 30 cal. These are the 44 grain pellets. We're gonna start at 50 yards. I'm just resting the front, because you know I like to get a feel for the gun, and I like this bullpup design. It feels good. I like this because you can cock it from up here up top and you don't have to take your finger off the trigger. I'm not gonna lie to you, that one happened by surprise. This trigger is light right now. It's set to be very touchy. And that one got away from me because I'm not gonna lie, it surprised me. I was not ready to pull that trigger. So. There we go. So, you know, look, that's a little all over the place for this gun. 864 is what we're seeing on the Crony. All right, let's get a new fill. Let's get it back up to 250 bar, and let's do a group down at 100 and see what we got. All right, here we go. 100 yards. That was my fault. Up a little low. 862. So 862 is, look, that's good. .875. So see, that was great. I mean, that's a pretty good group at 100 yards. I'm not gonna lie, there's some shooter error in there. I'm sure there's plenty of you guys can get a much tighter group, but this gun is putting it out there consistently. 875, 868. It's all right in. That's five shots. You know, that got us to about half from 250. We're about 225 bar. So we've got another good solid five shots with probably within five or six. Give it 10 feet per second, which is not going to affect your shot that much. That's it. I've shot all the paper I can. I want to go take this thing to the fun range, get some different targets, big sizes, little sizes. We're going to shoot all different distances and really show what this Daystate Renegade can do. Let's go. We're going to see if a 30 cal can get through all eight of those cans. Shall we? We shall. 3, 2. But let me just show what the 30 cal can do to a champagne bottle. Pow! Shaving cream, 60 yards. Let's move out to 100 yards. There's an egg. 100 yards egg off the top of a shaving cream bottle. That is some accuracy, son. The Renegade. How about that English dude? I'm gonna get him right in the ruffles. Oh, God, just knocked his arm off. Oh, grandma's container out there. By grandma's container. Bang, look at that, it's a direct hit. Let's finish it. Finish it. Instead of having garage sales, just send us your stuff that you don't want anymore. We'll take care of it, all right? I promise, no worries. I know the one thing that brings the Brits and the Americans together is watermelon. One final shot to bring us all together as one community of air gunners with the Daystate Renegade. Guys, that is it, man. This is the Daystate Renegade. You know, it's the mechanical version of the Pulsar with the hybrid trigger that's part mechanical and part electronic. That's it for this Rossi's review. I hope you guys have had as much fun as I've had. Thanks for watching.